Welcome to my YouTube channel Medical Knowledge, where learning medicine makes sense. Today I will discuss about common breast condition in a lactating mother, the mastitis. Bacterial mastitis is the most common type of mastitis and is commonly associated with lactation. The nasopharynx of an infant harbors Staphylococcus aureus in 50% of the cases. And when breastfeed on a sore or cracked nipple, this bacteria may cause an ascending infection. In case of retracted nipple, the lactiferous duct may get blocked by epithelial debris. The accumulation of milk in the ampulla of duct is torn to clot by Staphylococcus aureus, where it multiplies. If you like this video, please do subscribe to the channel. A patient with mastitis has all signs of acute inflammations like redness of skin, pain, swelling, and raised temperature. The initial stage is generalized cellulitis stage, which later evolves into abscess. Fluctuation in mastitis is a late finding. The area of induration initially involves one quarter, but later becomes more extensive. The diagnosis of a mastitis is clinical in a lactating mother, but the pus can be aspirated and sent for bacterial culture. Ultrasonogram of the breast may show abscess formation or antibioma. If an antibiotic is used in presence of undrained pus, an antibioma may form. Antibioma is a large, sterile and browny edematous swelling. The treatment of mastitis include antibiotic to cover Staphylococcus aureus, which may be flucloxacin or coamoxiclav. Breastfeeding should be continued if a patient can manage to do so. If not possible, milk should be drained out with the help of suction. Local application of heat can help relieve the pain, and painkiller like NSAIDs can be used. The recent practice is repeated aspiration under antibiotic treatment. Before, it used to be incision and drainage if it didn't resolve after 48 hours or there is an induration after milk was emptied. The benefits of repeated aspiration under antibiotic treatment are we can continue the breastfeeding and there are no scars of incision and drainage. If a nipple becomes cracked or sore during lactation, it should be rested for 24 to 48 hours and the breast should be emptied by using a pump. Feeding should be resumed as soon as possible. In case of retracted nipple, mechanical suction devices are in use with some effect. Minor cosmetic surgeries can produce an adequate correction but has a drawback of dividing the underlying ducts. The complication of mastitis include breast abscess. In case of breast abscess, incision and drainage should be done. Thank you for watching this video. If you like the content of this video, then please do subscribe to the channel.